Welcome to West Avenue Black History Program. Sit back and enjoy yourselves as we go back down memory lane, giving respect and honoring those who have paved the way for all people today. I present to you West Avenue Elementary, I Have a Dream.
Michael Joseph Jackson, born August 29, 1958, died June 25, 2009, was an American recording artist, actor, producer, dancer, and businessman. Offered to the nickname by King of Pop, his contribution to music, dance, and fashion, along with his personal lifestyle, made him a global figure in popularity cultures for over four decades. We all remember Michael Jackson, the King of Pop.
Barack Obama was born on August the 4th, 1961, in Hawaii. Barack Obama is the 44th and current president of the United States. Change will not come if we wait for some other person or some other time. We are the ones we've been waiting for. We are the change that we seek. We give honor to our president, Barack Obama.
Gabrielle Christina Victoria, Gabby Douglas, born December 31, 1995, is an American artistic gymnast. As a member of the U.S. women's gymnastic team at the 2012 Summer Olympics, she won gold medals in both the individual all-around and team competitions. Douglas is the first woman of color and the first African-American gymnast in the Olympic history to become the individual all-around champion and the first American gymnast to win gold medals in both the individual all-around team and competitions. At the same Olympics, as well as being the only American all-around champion to win multiple gold medals. She was also a member of the gold-winning U.S. team at the 2011 World Champions. We give honor to Gabrielle Christina Douglas.
Let every voice and sing to let them hear.
There is a voice that I hear from the very center of my heart. It is the voice of my parents and their parents and their parents and theirs. There is a voice I hear that speaks of dreams of all that have come before me. It is the dream of peace. It is the dream of freedom. The voice I hear is full of hope.
We have all come from many different lands. No two journeys have been the same. Yet we are all followers of dreams. We are all followers of dreamers.
Poverty or enslavement, prejudice or injustice, we find ways to carry on because we are dreamers. We lay down our burdens and we never ever give up.
There is a sound I hear. It is the sound of a powerful train No ordinary locomotive is this that is chugging along the iron railroads of my dreams.
It is an engine racing downhill and picking up energy from every person's dream of hope and freedom for all. There is room for all on this powerful train, so get on board on this train of freedom.
The Drinking Gourd is another name for the Big Dipper. Folklore has it the fugitive slaves of the United States use it as a point of reference so they will not get lost.
According to the legend, the song was used by a conductor of the Underground Railroad called Peg Leg Joe to guide some fugitive slaves. While the song may possibly refer to some lost fragments of history, the origin and context remains a mystery. A more recent source challenges the authenticity of the claim that the song was used to help the slaves escape to the north into freedom.
To carry you to freedom, follow the drinking. Go to the back of the bus, Rosa Parks. Go to the back and stay. No, I won't. I think that's unfair. And I'm just too tired today. But everyone knows the rules, Rosa Parks. Everyone knows if you're black. You can't eat at white restaurants, and on buses, you sit in the back. So now it's time to move, Rosa Parks. No, I'm not moving at all. I've got a voice, and I'm going to use it. And thousands will hear the call. We're coming to sit with you, Rosa Parks. People black and white did say, we're coming to change America and bring equality here to stay. We honor Rosa Parks till this day.
It was the most, We Shall Overcome was the most powerful song of the 20th century. It started out in church pews and picket lines, inspired one of the greatest freedom movements in the U.S. history, and one of the top level governments and bring about reform all over the world. Word for word, the short, simple lyrics of We Shall Overcome may be some of the most influential words in the English language.
We Shall Overcome has its roots in African-American hymns from the early 20th century and was first used as a protest song in 1945 when striking tobacco workers in Charleston, South Carolina sang it on their picket line. By 1950, the song has been discovered by young activists of the African-American Civil Rights Movement, and it quickly became the movement's unofficial anthem. Its verse were sung protest marchers and sit-ins through the clouds of tear gas and under rows of police batons and brought courage to comfort bruised, frightened activists as they waited in jail cells wondering if they would survive the night. When the long years of struggle ended, President Johnson vowed to fight for the voting for rights of for all Americans. He included the final promise, we shall overcome.
In the decades since the song has circled the globe and has been embraced by civil rights and pro-democracy movements in dozens of nations worldwide, from Northern Ireland to Eastern Europe, from Berlin to Beijing, from South Africa to South America, its message of solidarity and hope has been sung in dozens of languages. And in presidential palaces and in dark prisons, it continues to lend its message of strength to all people struggling to be free. As you listen to We Shall Overcome, think about the reasons that has brought strength and support to so many people for so many years. And remember that someone somewhere is singing it right now.